Amazing. So, hold on a second. So, this is a really lively room, and for that reason, tonight is going to be fun, because I don't think that you and me have been in a quiet environment like this before. So. So I think what if we set up some ground rules? First of all, the people. Hold on a second, I didn't finish, man. The people in the very upstairs. Apparently, the barrier that's up there is a little low. So, if you're going to go anywhere, go away from the barrier. And all day I've been drinking water because I'm trying to make sure I don't have any phlegm tonight. And then I've got. Now, just as I walked out here, I think the phlegm production inside my throat went up to 11. So, but I think it's nerves. I'm a little nervous, but seriously, so because, you know, it's kind of lively, again, when y'all, so in between the songs, here's the ground rules. In between the songs, you know, we can all go, but during the songs, just, you know, I mean, obviously, if you can't contain it, you know, I can't do anything about that, but overall, you know. But Seattle, I'm here a lot of the time nowadays, and Seattle's, gotta admit, pretty cool place. So, and I talk a lot when I'm nervous, so you'll have to put up with this crap. Yeah. Got all these picks over here, and they look weird when I do this. I got, let me just say a couple more things before I start. I can't hear myself that well, so I'll try and contain my nervous emotions. We have a Halloween seasonal theme going on up here. With the pumpkins. And that is, it's as if I didn't have enough to worry about playing by myself, I also realized that when I glanced in passing into the mirror on my way out here, that this shirt makes me look like I have big breasts.
That well. done wrong. But what I did, I thought needed be done, I swear. Oh, unholy day, if I leave now, I might get away. And God knows it weighs on me as heavy as stone and as blue as I go. I was just wondering if you'd come along, hold up my head when my head won't hold on. I'll do the same if the same's what you want, but if not, I'll go. And I forever pay. No run, I will run, and I'll be okay. But I was just wondering if you'd come along, hold up my head with my head on, hold on. I'll do the same if the same's what you want, but if not, I'll go. I will go a long way to bury the past, for I don't want to pay. Oh, how I wish this to turn back the clock and do it all over again. I was just wondering if you'd come along, hold up my head when my head won't hold on. I'll do the same if the same's what you want, but if not, I'll go. I will go along. Oh, I need so to stay in your arms, see your smile, hold you close. And God knows it weighs on me heavy as stone and a bone chilling cold. I was just wondering if you'd come along. Just tell me you will. Oh, only, oh, only, oh, only, only. Thank you very much. Yeah. Yeah.
One down. Hey, this is a cool place. Look, I'm this little lozenge. It's a tasty lozenge. Mm-hmm. Hope everybody's feeling good this evening. This chair was really comfy at soundcheck. Between soundcheck and now, I got a bunch of ants in my pants, and so now I'm having less comfort.
Tonight is 2 a.m. I'm drunk again, it's heavy on my mind. I could never love again so much as I love you. Where you end, where I begin is like a river going through. Take my eyes, take my heart, I need them no more. If never again they fall upon the one I so adore. Excuse me, please, one more drink. Could you make it strong? 'Cause I don't need to think she broke my heart, my grace is gone. One more drink and I move on. One drink to remember, then another to forget. How could I ever dream to find a love like you again? One drink to remember and another to forget. Excuse me, please, one more drink. Could you make it strong? 'Cause I don't need to think she broke my heart. One more drink and I'll move on. One more drink and I'll be gone. You think things impossible, then the sun refused to shine. When I woke with you beside me, your cold hand lay in mine. Excuse me, please, one more drink. Could you make it strong? 'Cause I don't need to think she broke my heart, my grace is gone. One more drink and I'll go. Excuse me, please, one more drink. Could you make it strong? 'Cause I don't need to think she broke my heart. One more drink and I'll move on. One more drink and I'll be gone. One more drink, my grace is gone.
Hold on a second. I'm not really good at tuning my instrument. Well. So let me just get this sort of tiresome thing out of the way and then. While I appreciate that. Got this thing in here. I think it sounds pretty good for me. It's got a quiet. Hold on one second. Just one second. Everybody, just stop running. Sounds pretty good to me. That sounds good to me. You see, and that's reassuring that some of you agreed. Until, you know. What happened? What's that? You were lying to me. You just wanted to see me screw it up. And so you could laugh. That was really great when he totally screwed it up.
On the ground.
dig it down, 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 down. Dig it down, 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 dig it down. Super down, 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 dig it down. Sa da ga da gum ba da ga da da. Dig it down, 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 dig it down. Super down, 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 dig it down. Super down, 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 dig it down. Super down, 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 dig it down. I will treat you sweetly. I adore you, I mean, you crush me, and it's times like these, oh my faith I feel, and I know just how I want you. Come on, lovely.
I've got a little shaky toward the end there. I think it's because of the lozenge. Thank you, everybody, very much. You know, love, 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 love. That one, sometimes, you know, sometimes things just, you know, I just get real excited and then. This is a tiny little song.
Gathered round to hear me sing my love out loud. Oh, 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 oh. You lightly lifted me away out of a darkness cold and gray, and I worked beneath the midday sun my cool blue water you have come. I give to you my everything, 'cause you've given me these loving wings, and angels have all gathered round to hear me sing my love out loud. Whoa, 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 whoa. Here next to me, and I'll take my place there next to thee. And no matter how far we may roam, it's by your side I'll make my home. I give to you my everything, 'cause you've given me these loving wings, and angels have all gathered round. You're missing my love out loud. Ooh, 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 ooh.
So, this song, I don't know why I want to do it tonight. Because I've never played it alone, and you know, maybe some of y'all, maybe it's not a favorite, but that's okay because I like it. But understand that I'm going into this with, you know, a relative amount of terror. I wish I could be
I don't care, this shirt makes me look like I got tits. I don't care. I don't care if I talk. I don't care.
But no, I'm like, yeah. Caution to the wind, then.
Look at me, dreaming of you. Oh, I could hope is to have you, to have you walking with me, laughing so in love. Strongly, I didn't buy all this fantasy of you. Come and whatever gets you through. You make a mess of me, was I fool? I'll dance a thousand steps for you. Was I fool? Am I fool to think? Am I fool for you?
Got this
I'm the most paranoid man I know.
Except this one guy I saw in the street the other day here saying, "Stop looking at me! Stop looking at me!" There's a one guy that would then had me licked. But if I'm not mistaken, at least the people here are looking at me.
John, have you seen the homeless daughters standing there with broken wings? I have seen the flaming sword there over east of Eden, burning in the eyes of the maker, burning in the eyes of the maker, burning in the eyes of the maker. Oh, river, rise from your sleep.
Thank you. I'm just afraid of the wave getting too big, you see, and because, you know, the wave could get too big, that's why I pulled my surfboard in. Thought I'd drag that metaphor out until it became absurd, but... That was me riding a surfboard. Knucklehead.
He stands, cuts his head, his shoes untied. Tongue gaping stare, could I have been a magnet for money? Could I have been anyone other than me? 23 and so tired of life, such a shame to throw it all away. The images grow darker still, could I have been anyone other than me? And up at the sky, my mouth is open wide. I can taste what's the use in worrying? What's the use in hurrying? Turn, turn, we almost become dizzy. Sky, my mouth is open wide. There can taste, what's the use of worrying? What's the use of hurrying? Turn, turn, we almost become dizzy. Almost become dizzy.
Thank you very much. Yeah, yeah, same. But sometimes I know I've the problem is it's been a while, so it's like scary in my head. I mean, but I hear you every time you say it. I just get scared. I'm just like, oh no, God, that's it. No, don't worry, but it's not that you shouldn't feel bad. I really have a really weird guilt problem that so like if someone's is going, you know, play Stairway to Heaven, I don't think that was, I think like, wow, I really should learn that. And it's, I have a problem like that, you know. Demands. There was that one plea right there after I didn't know which song he asked for, but at the end he said, come on, man. That's sweet of him. That was nice of him. The other day, sorry, I have to do this because if I don't do it, then it's going to be just going through my head through the whole song. Like, so, the other day, I'm with a friend. We're messing around with some songs, so we spent some days. We're messing around. It's pretty good. Anyway, the other day, my friend Monk, who comes out here every once in a while to say, take this guitar. He was there too, but we drank. We drank a lot of coffee, man. And then, you know, sometimes when you drink, I mean, like now, if I had coffee right now, I'd just be crying in front of everybody. But sometimes, because a lot, probably those of you that are from Seattle, you all know from a young age that you're like Cubans, you know? You know, don't drink too much coffee. Like, you started this big, but see, then I came from Virginia and hang out here a lot. And then we're like, oh yeah, man, look, this coffee's really good, tastes really good, like, kind of like a milkshake, you know? And you, oh, it's so good, let's get it, what do we do now? Let's have some coffee, man. Oh. And the next thing you know, you're just like, oh man, oh, what's happening to me? And that wasn't even a story, I don't think. Needless to say, we all left. What happens to you is when you have too much coffee, I think, maybe y'all will disagree, but you get really cranky. Like, you go crazy, and then everyone's just like, then you're just cranky. Everyone's like, what do you want to do? Get irritable. And you can't have any more coffee. Sorry, I apologize for the time wasted in that monologue there. Tonight I'm going to dedicate this song to the hopes that there's peaceful solutions. Thank you.
away like an ocean that you can't see but you can smell, and the sound the waves crash down. I am no Superman. I have no answer for you. I am no hero, that's for sure. But I do know one thing, that's where you are is where I belong. I do know where you go is where I wanna be. Where are you going? Where do you go? Are you looking for answers to questions under the stars? If along the way you are growing weary, you can rest with me till a brighter day and you're okay. I am no Superman. I have no answers for you. I am no hero, that's for sure. But I do know one thing, that's where you are is where I belong. I do know where you go is where I wanna be. Where are you going? Where do you go?
See, I thought about maybe saying, I am no Spider-Man. But I got a great story. This is one of my heroes that I've had the honor and the great luck of getting to know is this guy named Willie Nelson. And my story was a lie, that little one about Spider-Man. But he had a great one for me. I told him, you know, I was into Willie. You know, it was cool. And then it sounds weird when you say I was into Willie. Anyway, aren't we all? But he told me. I told him. Well, then after I already liked him as a kid, then I found out that he wrote that song Crazy. And I kind of, the way he sings Crazy, I took that for crush because I thought it was the baddest line in the world. And I had to start the song with my tribute to Willie. Crazy, you know. Crazy, I'm crazy for you. Anyway, but he told me. Hold on a second. Then he told me that it originally was stupid. I'm stupid for feeling so lonely. Stupid for me. And then he changed it, but that probably wouldn't have sold as many records, but. Yeah.
Stupid. Stupid for lying, stupid for crying. I'm stupid for loving you. Shut up, okay.
Between the lines, I'm gonna pack more lines so I get that thing. Damn this traffic jam. Got time to keep that sand. I suck it up like I lick it up. I get up till I got room for no more. Cause I eat too much, yeah. I drink too much, I put up too much. Too much. As I dig it up, bam, bam, bam. You know, you gotta get it somewhere.
Calm down,
okay.
Calm down, okay.
I shoot God, yeah, coming to your neck down. Stomach full, not a chip on my shoulder. I got this growl in my tummy. I'm gonna stop today. Just eat too much, drink too much, use up too much, too up too much, I eat too much, drink too much, use up too much,
Yeah. Later.
You know, this is a big sounding guitar here. I'm gonna, just because I'm nervous and I tend to jump off of things when I'm nervous.
Pardon?
You cannot quit me so quickly. There's no hope in you for me. No corner you could squeeze me. But I got all the time for you, love. The space between the tears we cry is the laughter keeps us coming back for more. The space between all our wicked lies is where we hope to keep safe from the pain. But will I hold you again? Will I hold you again? These fickle, fuddle words confuse me. Like, will it rain today? We waste the hours with talking. It's twisted games we're playing. We're strange allies with warring hearts. What a wild-eyed beast you be. The space between all our wicked lies is where we hope to keep safe from the spinning off in the madness of a roller coaster. You know you went off like the devil in the church in the middle of a crowded room. All I can do, my love, is hope we don't tame this ship down. The space between where you're smiling high, where you find me if I get to go. Space between our bullets and our firefight is where I'll be hiding, waiting for you. The rain would fall, smashing your heart, and light sadness down the window into your room. The space between all our wicked lies is where we hope to keep safe from. Cause we're walking out of here. Love is all we need, dear. The space between what's wrong and right, where you find me hiding, waiting for you. The space between your heart and mine is the space with the space we fill with time. That's one of the things you can do with this chair.
There's another one. They were similar, but...
Mm-hmm.
ass monk over there.
Thank you, everybody, so much for coming out tonight for the obvious reasons and love. Because, bring out the babies. They're probably resting, and then if we brought them out here, it'd freak them out, and then,
gotta get them back to sleep somehow, then.
Oh, great idea. I dug them out there. Everyone started screaming, and then they were just freaked out, and one of them bit me. No, but thank you so much for coming out here. I just want to thank everybody that helped organize it too, and hope that the money that we've raised together can help out a little bit.
Deep in the ground. When I say when I was young, I never think about it. Now I can't get it out of my mind. I'm on bended knees, oh, bartender, please. Bartender,
everybody's having an okay evening so far. Hope everybody's enjoying it a little bit tonight. Pardon?
Want a piece of me? I always love it because it's, you know, there's a, because the, you know, the voices that scream, because, you know, you, I understand you need it. And then there's, you know, and then there's always one person that just gets so frustrated, and then they go, play what you want. And that was when I go, you know, I was like, right on, man. Thanks for being there. But the truth is that I really wish that I could play what y'all want, but I don't. This is a song. It's a song. No kidding. I'll have a nice Halloween. Yeah, fat chance.
Cyrus Jones, 1810 to 1913, made his great-grandchildren believe you could live to 103. 103 is forever when you're just a little kid. Cyrus Jones, live forever, grave digger. When you dig my grave, could you make it shallow so that I can feel the rain? Grave digger. Muriel Stonewall, 1903 to 1954. lost both of her babies in the Second Great War. Now you should never watch your only children lowered in the ground. I mean, you should never have to bury your own babies, grave digger. When you dig my grave, could you make it shallow so that I can feel the rain, grave digger? Ring around the rosy, pocket full of posies, ashes to ashes. We all fall down, grave digger. When you dig my grave, could you make it shallow so that I can feel the rain, grave digger? Little Mikey Carson, 67 to 75, rode his bike like the devil until the day he died. When he grows up, he wants to be Mr. Vertigo on the flying trapeze. Or 1940 to 1992, grave digger. When you dig my grave, could you make it shallow so that I can feel the rain? Oh, grave digger, when you dig my grave, could you make it shallow so that I can feel the rain? I can feel.
Thank you very much. I haven't done this one either. Look, looks. Wait. I don't know, some of the things I don't recognize.
And my thumb, well, you take care of it, please. It's the only one there is. Oh, it'd take me a lifetime, old man, to remedy what you did. To remedy what you did. Oh, come on now, boy, think. Oh, what would Jesus do? He'd shake his head like an angry mother, spoke the boy, and say, I did what I could. Care of it, please. It's the only one. It'll take you a lifetime, boy,
to undo what we'd done. The boy shrugged and walked away. The man stood and watched as he was leaving. The boy just walked away. The man stood there thinking. One hand is bleeding, the other hand holds a gun. Everything seems okay, or is everything falling down? What you got in your head? Your secret safe with me. Well, I found the truth, Dad. Want me to whisper in your ear? You take care of it, please. It's the only one there is. Come on now, boy, can I twist it, please? Could I give it just a little twist? The boy shrugged and walked away. The man stood and watched as he was leaving. The boy just walked away. The man stood alone thinking. One hand is empty, the other hand holds a gun. Is everything is open or is everything shut down? No one is holy. Even if you're sure, you never know it all. And the ground beneath you is nothing more than your point of view. Stood there twisting.
Thanks everybody again so much for coming here, and I hope that I played just the right amount, not too much, which is kind of hard for me because usually I too long. And so this time I just wanted to say thank you for everybody, and for all the times that I didn't quite hit it, I apologize, and for the times that were truly tremendous, and almost the times that were almost from the far beyond, those times you're welcome. Once again, I'm going to try something that seems now really stupid of me.
Stay for a while. I was kissing you. You were kissing me, love, from a good day we went to the moonlight. And now a night so fine made me wanna stay.
Everybody, very, very much for coming here. Y'all take care of yourself and look after each other. Ride, you know, walk when you can't drive, something like that. Right on.
So thanks everybody, you know, play some quiet song and then some, right. I thought, you know, I get worried that I'm going on too much, but it's because I talk a lot, I'm nervous and everything.
I've known no other, and for sure we've danced in the risk of each other. Would you like to dance around the world with me?
Thank you, everybody, very much. Yeah. Just as talking to the girls backstage, they're my little girls. One of them wanted to come out here, but she'd get really freaked out. Look. Freak her out, man. She's eating an avocado right now. Can't get between her and her avocados. Just like you couldn't get between Brooke Shields and her Calvin Kleins.
You like to play? Well,
Nothing new, but simple and touching. This is a song by the guy who wrote Stupid.
Well, hello there. My, it's been a long, long time. How you doing? How am I doing? I guess I'm doing fine. It's been so long, but it seems like it was only yesterday. Oh, ain't it funny how time slips away? Your new love, I hope is doing fine. I heard you told him, I heard you say you love him till the end of time. Now that's the same thing that you told me, it seems like only yesterday. Ain't it funny how time slips away? Well, I got to go now, yeah, and I guess I'll see you around. I don't know when though, 'cause I don't know when I'll be back in town. Remember what I tell you, 'cause in time you're gonna pay. It's surprising how time slips away. Ain't it funny how time slips away? Sitting at the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away.
funny how time slips away.
Now, see, I'm kind of like pretty straightforward when it comes to writing music, but then every once in a while I like to be avant-garde.
How you like them apples? How you like them apples?
There's so many ways to this world, you're fighting this every time. There's too many ways to this every time. Too many vehicles, I mean. Too many vehicles, I mean. Too many vehicles, I mean. Too many vehicles, I mean.
Thank you. Now, then you clapped, and now you got more than you bargained for. Look at this thing, man. You know that there was a time when people that could afford it and then people that couldn't afford it, they all had leather-soled shoes that were real popular. They're still popular now, but now it's not as common. But you know what happens with leather-soled shoes is that you eat it all the time. So these boots I bought, I didn't. I stole them from a photo shoot, which I think means that the record company probably took it out of my wages. Anyway, but then I was falling down. I liked them because I thought they look a little edgy, you know, for me, which isn't all that edgy, just a little bit edgy. And then I kept on falling down everywhere, like outside of my house in the pave, walking it like across the street. Nothing happening. Just all of a sudden, whoop, bam! And you know, like just the grade here, you know, just the grade of a driveway, just like that. So, whoop, bam! And then I dropped my mom at the doctor. To visit with the doctor here. She wanted to go to a naturopath, so I said, hey, got a bunch of them. So when you're out here, we'll take you to one. They're all over the place up here in the Northwest. I know in Virginia, you couldn't find a naturopath if you had like a hound dog with you, with a naturopath shirt, like at his, you know, smell this, buddy, go get a naturopath. Can't do it, but. But I was dropping my mom off at the doctor, and you know, and then as I was leaving, I noticed just to the right of the stairs that I was going to go down, that it said, "Caution, slippery stairs. Be, you know, grab the handrail." And I was going for the handrail. And it's a foo foo, bam. And I went down all the stairs, like, yeah, down the stairs. It would have been America's funniest home video. But thank goodness, nobody was filming it. And then I had to, you know, I got a really weird story for you. It's not that good. The reason I was reminded of it was because my pride was injured, understandably, by falling down the stairs when there was a sign at the top of the stairs that, warning, caution, grab the handrail or you're gonna, you know, especially if you have leather sole shoes. Anyway, see, I've fixed them. I put, my wife had them, someone put some stuff on them so that now, I got grip. But I'm sorry to
to all of you that expected some level of music to be going on. Now that it turns out that it's just sort of some idiot rambling with occasional semi-musical events interspersed into the mix. But look. I don't know why I'm doing this so much tonight. It's a weird thing. It's like I'm hitchhiking. I want to go somewhere. Hey, anywhere. Where are you going? Get me. Take me to your leader. So, anyway, because I was reminded by the humiliation, and I think I might be the only person in the world that this has ever happened to. It's not a great story. It's a boring story, okay? It's not that good, but I'm telling it anyway. What was happening was I was riding with some friends, my wife and a couple friends that farming friends, and we were out on the farm riding horses, and they gave me Bob. Bob is like was not a cart horse. He was like a carriage horse. So you know at Wed Hit he's retired now, but he used to be a carriage horse. And Bob, so Bob could take it, because you know if you have a carriage that's you just got married and you're gonna ride off on the carriage, you don't want a horse that could be like, oh my God, and just freak out. And, run you like spinning and rampant in the blood, and the white dress is ruined and the groom is decapitated. So what I mean is that Bob is really chilled out. So with Kevin, who was with me, who sort of helps take care of some of the property that I have back in Virginia, his good friend of mine, he gave me Bob, and he said that, he would always say, like, if a bear comes, because we saw some bears on the farm out there, they said, if a bear comes, you guys just hold on, because the horses, they're cool and everything, and they'll listen to you, but if a bear's around, like, they just have to see the bear, like, over the way, they'll go, a horse will just, apparently, I don't know, I'm not a horse psychologist, but apparently, a bear is something that a horse is not down with. And so apparently, it's not like wee wee. It's like poof. It's not like a Hollywood horse, It just hits the road. So, but then he clarified. He said, Bob might not run. Bob might, So I was psyched to have Bob, because if you told Bob. This is the good thing, I'm not a great rider. I look a little bit, it's kind of probably amusing to watch me ride, but I like it. And I get, I've fallen off a few horses and I get right back on them. So I figure, now I know what it's like to fall off a horse. But anyway, I was on Bob. Bob is chilling out. He goes to those kick, and then he runs, if you ask him to, hit it, Bob. Then Bob hits it, and sometimes you get that smooth, and Bob is really turning on the gas when you're going chrome, 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 and all of a sudden it's like, and then it gets smooth, I don't know if you ride, sometimes when it gets smooth, that's a good feeling. It's a little bit scary though, it's like me skiing, it's both really bad, I'm the guy who people are flying past on the ski slope, and the guy, then the secure, I don't even know they had security guys on ski slopes until some guy said, slow down, you're skiing beyond your ability. Screw you. Anyway. So, back to Bob. So, Bob and me and Kevin and a bunch of people were riding the horses. I'm sorry, I'll get on with it now. So, We slowed down by the fishing hole just to chill out for a while, and a friend of mine who's riding a different horse. The bit is like the bit goes. Sometimes the bit comes out of the mouth and goes,
And sometimes it comes out of the mouth and it goes, weir, weir. And sometimes, but this time, this horse had a bit that came out and went, weir. See, that was the horse's bit, not Bob's. Bob's bit was like this or something. This horse's bit was like this. And then it was walking, the horse was walking up next to me. And I think it must have had an itch or something. And it just like nuzzled up against my leg over here. Here and then I said to the horse, these were my last words. I said, don't bite me. And I was sort of being, hey, I'm a farmer. I can take it. And then the horse, I guess, was listening to me and tried to move its head, but the bit was in my pants. So the horse did a thing like, if I do this, see, that's not that impressive if I go like this. But when a horse does that, it's a great gesture. It's like a big gesture, like if I do this. That's not that impressive. But when a horse does that gesture, that very same gesture, it's like this. And so then what happened was that it was in my pants. So then one of my friends that was riding with me is here right now. And he, if you don't believe me, he'll tell you. Fenton is here and he was there. And anyway, what happened was, wait a second. It threw me way up in the air. And my legs, Fenton, this is what Fenton said. I don't remember this because I landed like Spider-Man on all fours maybe, but favoring my legs. But Fenton swears that both my legs were above my head at one point. That's what he said anyway. But the funny looking part was when my knee went first, so it must have looked funny, because like I was doing like the super Charleston. You know, it's like, I went, and then I went out. Anyway. That was when, and then I fell off. But what I was saying was that I think that I'm the only man that was ever thrown off of a horse by another horse. And just now that the story's over, a little postscript here. When I got up and walked around the front of Bob, who hadn't taken one step in the whole, he might have, while I wasn't looking, while I was concentrating on my landing, Bob may have maybe stepped a little bit, but I don't think so. I think Bob was, so that when I walked around in front of Bob, I got a sense that he might have said, hey. Thank you.
Got a good friend that that is here tonight. That I used to play this song in Holland and in the Netherlands, and he used to sell bracelets, and I'd play this song around and around. I didn't actually play as much as I should have because I was a little afraid, but. But it was a good song because it just went round and round and round the same chords. And I haven't stopped playing it. It's been like nearly like 200 years. But I hope I try and keep it interesting for myself.
Bye.
not a joke, but you and I, we've been through that. And this is not our fate. So let us not talk falsely now. The hour is getting late.
Thank you very much.